Hey there, I'm Ranger Nic with the Extinct Park Service, coming to you today from the Pleistocene in what will someday become Arizona. Now, we're here today because we're searching for a large mammal known as Paramylodon harlani, one of North America's many species of ground sloth. So, grab your boots and let's go. Oh, spring. Seasonal rains have left the soil spongy and the lake full. Increasing temperatures and longer days signal to many plants that it's time to bloom. This is a yellow pine parkland, and it's what used to make up a good chunk of northern Arizona. Approximately 18,000 years before your time. But what exactly is a yellow pine parkland? Well, its key feature is the stands of ponderosa pines. But between these pines, you'll also see clusters of shrubs, such as serviceberries, small trees, such as gamble oaks, and a rich underlayer of grasses and herbaceous plants. Due to wildfires, the stands of ponderosa pines are frequently thinned, allowing light to stream through their broken canopy. This, in turn, promotes new growth to flourish underneath. Combine all this luscious growth with that lake over there, and we have the perfect place to spot our furry friend, Paramylodon. You see, Paramylodon rarely wanders far from a water's edge, especially one lined with such lush foliage. This is exactly why... Hold up. That, my friends, is Panthera onca, a jaguar. As you may know, jaguars are still around during your time, and they are currently the third largest big cat on Earth, sometimes reaching 100 kilograms or 220 pounds. However, that's during your time. During my time, they could actually grow to be about 20% larger, sometimes reaching 120 kilograms or about 260 pounds. That's a big cat. Jaguars are skilled predators with a bite so powerful, they're known to kill by piercing the back of their prey's skull with their canines. So, to keep my skull unpierced, we're gonna try to keep a distance. Let's keep moving, shall we?
But it wasn't long until we found exactly what we came for.
Look, there it is. It's in the lake. Paramylodon harlani, one of North America's most widespread species of ground sloth, ranging from coast to coast, all the way from modern day Mexico into Canada. It is thought that the sloth's wide range was partially enabled by waterways such as these. by hanging around lakes and the streams and rivers that connect them, it's possible that these sloths were able to use it as a highway of sorts to cut through otherwise unlivable land. Paramylodon is both a grazer and a browser. It is likely that this trait also contributed to their large range. By being adapted to eating a variety of foods, they could avoid directly competing with other herbivores in the area. Much like extant sloth species, ground sloths possess some pretty sizable claws. But you won't find these guys using them to hang upside down from trees. Instead, Paramylodon use their claws more like gardening tools, using them to dig up plants from the roots or shear leaves off the branches. Whoa, there's that jaguar from earlier. And look, she's not alone. She's a mother. No wonder she's on guard. Notice how the jaguar is maintaining a defensive position instead of pouncing? She realizes she has little chance of besting this beast. In addition to its massive size, Paramylodon is armored with osteoderms, bony deposits embedded within their skin. Even with a well-placed bite, a killing blow would be difficult to deliver. At this point, her only priority is the safety of the next generation. Looks like her intimidation play worked. Her cubs are safe, and the sloth has no interest in unnecessarily expending any energy. And thank goodness, because that could have gotten a lot messier. Thank you so much for tuning in today. I really hope you enjoyed today's excursion. If you did, please consider liking and subscribing, as all of this is only possible through viewers like you. And please let me know in the comments where and when you would like to explore in the future. Or should I say the past? If you're curious about any of the topics I talked about here today, please check the sources at the end of the video. And a huge thank you to all the researchers out there who work every day to uncover the history of life on Earth. Stay curious and stay kind. I'll see you next time.